You are in the rant stream where I rant about whatever my $10 a month plus patrons want me to rant about. You can get one of these by being one of those. This one's for Nisio. He's seen Shill, who says, rant about why you haven't finished watching the Monogatari anime yet. 42 episodes have come out since you finished with Hanamonogatari and the Kizu trilogy. What in your life, both now and over the past few years, is stopping you from finishing a series you enjoyed that is ripe for analysis and has a large fan base? Well, really, what it comes down to is that it just kept going, and I never knew where was like a good jumping back in point or if I wanted to continue my previous writing of it, because I did a big ass video of it back in 2014, Monogatari, an in-depth, fucking, what is it called? Mindful Self-Indulgence, a Monogatari analysis. So I did that. It got pretty decent views. A lot of people enjoyed that video. I enjoyed making it at the time. There are some people who really have problems with it, who say that some of my suppositions about particularly Nisei Monogatari are based on like mistranslations and stuff like that of things that Nisei Oisin himself had said. You know, listening back to the whole thing, I think it's an unevenly written project. It's not necessarily the most interesting angle of approach to the series. I'm sure if I watched it again, I would have different things to say about it. So, you know, for a while, it was like, at some point, I'm going to do part two of the Monogatari, you know, mindful self-indulgence video. But like, and I mean, to begin with, the most interesting part of that video is earlier on when I'm talking about the first season, comparing it to Nisei Mono. When you start getting into second season, it becomes more just basically like a kind of a review of each arc, which again is not the most interesting way to even tackle the material in my mind. So like, you know, it was originally, when will I do part two of Monogatari's whatever? And I thought I'll do it once it's over. Just not thinking it would continue forever. Like, particularly when Owari Monogatari came out, I thought that was the end. And then there was Owari Mono second season. There was the Koyomi Monogatari. You know, they just kept adding more. And now I think the light novels are publishing again. So at this point, it's not even a matter of waiting for it to be over, because I don't know if it will ever be truly over, you know. I would have to restart from the beginning one way or another, and now there's like 100 episodes. So, like, you know, I have not tackled really any super long anime in like super in-depth way besides like Hunter x Hunter. I've made a few longer reviews about because there's so much to talk about that show, but I've never made like a super in-depth analytical piece on any show that was, you know, probably even as long as the Monogatari series was when I did the one I did on it. It was a huge project. It took like 2 weeks. Just, you know, and it's set to video game footage. Like, it was just pure watching and writing for weeks. So, like, I can't imagine it going any faster if I did it again, you know, and now I have twice as much to watch. So, like, you know, could I just watch it for my own enjoyment? Absolutely. You know, I've thought about just watching it with May, because I think you'd like it, and you haven't seen basically more than like 5 episodes of the first season, right?
I've seen half of the first season.
So like,
and I did like what I saw.
You know, we could watch it at some point just for the hell of it. Maybe I'll have ideas. Maybe I'll have an angle I want to approach it from. But you know, in my mind, there's always an infinite number of great things that I know I'll enjoy that I haven't consumed. That is a fact of reality. It is not a huge hang-up for me. And I understand why for other people who are like, but you gave it like a 9 out of 10. Wouldn't that mean you have to continue it? And it's like, there's not a lot of things I give a 9 out of 10 to. I would love to know that there's more, you know, to know that like I don't try to just seek out just watching all the best stuff and then having nothing left. Because again, there will always be more good stuff that I haven't seen, you know. I can take my time, get to it when I get to it, when I feel like it, basically. Haven't felt like it enough, I guess. So, yeah, that's what it comes down to.